Dear students, now we are going to discuss about the standard deviation. We have already gone through range, quartile and mean deviation, and now once again we are trying to summarize and to know what is the meaning of the standard deviation. Just you look the summary of the measure of dispersion. The summary measure is, as we have already gone through and you know, the central tendency means mean, median and mode, and variation means the range, quartile deviation, mean deviation, that is the also called measure of dispersion or variation. And the last we are going to study standard deviation. This is about the family tree of the measures. Okay, now what is the standard deviation? Just to look a little history, while looking at the earlier measures of dispersion, all of them suffers from one or the other demerits. How? The range, it suffers from a serious drawback. Consider only two values and neglect all the other values of the series. While that, quartile deviation consider only 50% of the item and ignores the other 50% of item in the series. What is the mean deviation? No doubt an improved measures, but ignores negative signs without any basis. Okay, it means the concept of standard deviation was first introduced by Carl Pearson in 1893. Carl Pearson, after observing all these things, means all the measures he has observed, and then he has given us a more scientific formula for calculating and measuring dispersion. While calculating standard deviation, we take deviations of individual observations from their arithmetic mean and then each squares. The sum of the squares is divided by the total number of observations. The square root of this sum is known as standard deviation. In two lines, this is the general definition of standard deviation. The standard deviation is the most useful and the most popular measure of dispersion, and it is reliable and realistic also. So people always, oftenly in all the sectors, the people always use this deviation. It is always calculated from the arithmetic mean, median and mode is not considered. Okay, now standard deviation is the positive square. This is the positive square root of the average of square deviation taken from arithmetic mean. The standard deviation is represented by Greek letter sigma, and the formula, the first formula you can note, is this sigma is equal to under root summation of x minus x bar whole square by n. Okay, here x bar is the mean. So now standard deviation also uses this formula. Okay, first formula you know, summation of x minus x bar whole square by n, the same may be written like this. And the same is already the sigma may be divided and distributed, and then you may write like this: summation of x square by n minus 2x bar summation of x by n plus summation of x bar whole square by n, and then from here to here you can write, and in the last you will get this result, which is very important: is summation of x square by n minus x bar square, and x bar square can may also written like this: is summation of x by n whole square. So it means this is the very important formula and very useful, is sigma is equal to under root summation of x square by n minus summation of x bar by n whole square. You must remember this formula for calculation of standard deviation. Now just you look this key individual how and which kind of the method we are going to use. So by taking deviation of the item from the actual mean, and by taking deviation of the item from an assumed mean. So case when the deviation are taken from the actual mean, then the direct method say ki sigma is equal to summation of x I minus x bar whole square by n, or we may also define summation of d square by n, where d stand for x I minus x bar. Here x I is the value of the variable observation, x bar is arithmetic mean, and n is total number of observations. Now you look the problem, very interesting problem. You find the mean respiration rate per minute as and its standard deviation when in four cases the rate was found to be 16, 13, 17, and 22. So mean is quite easy, and you may calculate that is 17. Now x, this is the table for x, is all the values 16, 13, 17, and 22. D means this deviation, x minus x bar, so minus 1, minus 4, 0, and 5. D square, 1, 16, 0, and 25. This sum is 68, and this sum is D square is 42. Now you will put the value here, the summation of xi minus x bar whole square by n, the summation of D square by n, 42 by 4 is 3.2. So here you will get 3.2. Now the second case, when the deviation are taken from assumed mean, then in that case, shortcut method is sigma is equal to summation of d square by n minus summation of d by n whole square. D is x minus a is assumed mean, and n is total number of observations. Therefore, just you do another problem, that is blood serum cholesterol level of 10% are as under 240, 260, 290, 245, 255. This is a very obvious problem. 288, 272, 263, 277, 251. Calculate the standard deviation with the help of assumed mean. Okay, calculate the standard deviation with the help of assumed mean. Now values are already given. Total number of observations are 10. Here you can take x minus 8. A assumed mean is 264. Already it is there. 264 may be assumed mean. Okay, here you can calculate. This is already x bar is a plus summation of d by n. A is 264. And plus 1 by 10, 263.9, it means 263.9. Okay, so you may calculate like this. Already, this is summation of d. Summation of d is 1. This is minus and plus. So already, you may calculate this as a 1. Okay, and now d square is this. Summation of d square 2689. Now you put the value and you will get 16.398. Thank you very much. Thank you. Stay safe.